I'm here with boxing expert Doug Fisher to talk about the fight that everyone's talking about. Andre Ward, Chad Dawson, Antonio DeMarco against John Molina Jr.
That's a good doubleheader. I'm actually doing a Fox Sports Net broadcast. If I wasn't doing that broadcast on September 8th, I would be in Oakland because I love fights in the Bay Area. And I actually, you know, I covered Andre Ward's title-winning effort against Mikkel Gessler in late 2009 at the Oracle Arena, and that was a great atmosphere. And I was there for one of his title offenses against Alan Green. That was also part of the Super Six tournament. That was also at the Oracle Arena. Nice atmosphere. This atmosphere, I think, for this fight is going to be much greater because now Andre Ward is really the undisputed champion at 168 pounds, and he's fighting the undisputed champ at 175 pounds. The light heavyweight champ, Chad Dawson, is coming down to 168 pounds to fight Andre Ward. Two really good boxers. Nice, complete boxers who've got speed, they've got power, they've got good technique. I favor Andre Ward, like a lot of people do. And the reason is, it's just that I think Ward has proven that he's got this style that adapts to other styles, and I think particularly to boxers. He's figured out a way to neutralize tall, strong, fast boxers. He did it against Mikkel Gessler. He found a way to take away Kessler's jab, and Gessler wasn't much without that jab. And he did it against Alan Green, who's also a boxer. And Alan Green is, you know, a dangerous boxer puncher. And we saw what Andre Ward did in that fight. He shut Green down for all 12 rounds. It was a shutout, a unanimous shutout decision victory for Ward. And what did he do? He mugged him for 12 rounds.
We saw what he did against Carl Froch with one hand. So.
Absolutely. Carl Froch, he's not as technically smooth, technically polished as Chad Dawson, but he's a big, rangy guy who's very smart and rugged and very durable. And I think Dawson's going to come to fight. I think he's going to bring just as much desire, if not more, than those previous Ward opponents that we brought up, Gessler, Ward, and Froch. The bottom line is that Ward finds a way to win, and he often does so in dominant fashion. I don't think he's going to dominate this fight, but I think at some point in this fight, he's going to figure out the range, get past that jab, and just get into Chad Dawson's chest and kind of smother him for the rest of the fight. And I think he's going to win those rounds. So I favor Ward by a close but unanimous decision.
Okay, so now break down the undercard. I think that this could be fight of the year.
I think it's fight of the night. I tell you what, we could talk about, you know, the technical precision of Ward and Dawson. But really the fight of the night. And yeah, you're right. Klitschko's also on that broadcast. I expect Klitschko to take out Char, you know, by the mid round. So that's not a competitive fight. This lightweight fight between DeMarco and Molina is a competitive fight. And, I look at DeMarco as a more complete fighter. He's a better boxer, certainly a better technician. Guy who knows how to, you know, work off his jab and work very well off his jab with, straight lefts and combinations. But he is an aggressive fighter by nature. And I think all of his fights kind of follow a similar pattern where he's boxing from a distance, slowly working his way into the fight, and really by like fifth or sixth round, midway through the fight, he begins to apply pressure. He wants to try to break the guy down. And one thing we know about John Molina, he's a big lightweight, he's physically strong, he's got knockout power in both hands, and he will take a beating. I think he proved that in the Hank Lundy fight. You can be leading, you can be putting it on him. He's not going to give up, and he's dangerous even in the late rounds. So if you take the fight to John Molina in the late rounds of a fight, particularly a grueling fight, you're going to play right into those heavy hands. So I think Molina is a live underdog.
Yeah,
really
tell you something about him. He's dropped every sparring partner he's had.
That's what he does. He's got tremendous power. And, I know DeMarco's tough. DeMarco wasn't dropped by Edwin Valero. But really, after about eight rounds against Edwin Valero, DeMarco was done. Now, the fight was stopped after 10 rounds. I think it probably should have been stopped sooner because he was in a bad way. And by no means am I comparing John Molina with Edwin Valero. Edwin Valero was a dynamic boxer who had knockout power and he could move and all of that. But I do think that, you know, Molina being kind of a flat-footed guy, kind of being, you know, a guy who's easy to hit, easy to jab, certainly, that's going to entice DeMarco to step forward. And I just think if you take the fight to Molina, you're a knockout waiting to happen. So honestly, I would not be surprised. I'm not a betting man, but if I was, I would bet some significant money on John Molina to score a late round stoppage.
There you have it. You heard Doug Fisher. Now, if you guys bet, don't blame him. It's your money. FaceMovieReporting.com. I'm Isaac Back reporting. So one more thing, Doug.